Helped us, that is why we have also gathered here. It is because he has helped us, he has kept us, he has preserved us. So bless the name of the Lord, exalt his holy name, magnify him. It's okay if you have not fasted, if you did not participate in the fast, but pray, lift up your voice and appreciate him, exalt his holy name. There is none like unto you. We thank you, we bless your name. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your enablement. Thank you for carrying us through. There is none like unto thee. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, our divine helper. Glory be to your name, O God. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. I want to thank the Lord specially for carrying us through the one, carrying us through yesterday. And of course, he has carried us through today. I want us to thank him one more time. I want us to thank him for strength. I want us to thank him for his enablement. Thank him, especially for the fast, for the prayer and fasting. Thank him, As you are thanking him also, thank him for answered prayers. Thank him because every time we call upon him, he answered us. So open your mouth and thank him. Open your mouth and thank him. You need not worry about whether you have seen the physical manifestation, but give him thanks because of the truth the Lord has done it, and you will see the manifestation. Open your mouth and bless the name of our God. Open your mouth and exalt his holy name. Open your mouth and give him the praise. We give you praise. We thank you. We appreciate you. Thank you for day one. Thank you for day two. Even thank you for day three. Thank you for answering our prayers. Because unto you all flesh have come. Unto you we have come, O God, in this exercise. And we thank you because you hear us always and you answer our prayers. Therefore, we thank you for every petition. We thank you for every supplication. We thank you for answered prayers. Glory be to your name. Be thou exalted. Be thou magnified. Glory to your name, O God. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. I'd like for us to lift up our voice and also ask the Lord for mercy. Have you seen something? Psalm 19 verse 11 says, who can understand his errors? He said, cleanse thou me from secret faults. You are going to lift up your voice and you are going to pray. And you know what that tells me? It is even possible you are fasting and you see. Somebody will say, what is this young man saying? What have I done that is wrong? Perhaps deliberately, unknowingly, but want to lift up our voice. We are not leaving any room for the devil to hold on any ground. And we are going to say, Lord, show us your mercy. Show us your mercy as individuals, as families, as a church, as a nation. Lord, show us your mercy. Lift up your voice and pray. Lord, show us your mercy. We come unto you on the platform of mercy this evening. Lord, ask him. You know our frame. The spirit of man, O God, is your candlestick, searching the inward parts of the belly. Have mercy upon us. Forgive us of every unrighteousness by the reason of the blood. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
If you have been looking through the scriptures, you would have seen variously how these people were greatly helped. If you have also been on the prayer line, is it about Samaria that everything, you know, was not just going on well? Even to the woman that cried to the king and said, King, you must find me something. The king said, even me, I cannot help you. Except God. And God indeed responded when the prophet spoke that by this time tomorrow, I believe that we will understand the story now. And by this time tomorrow, God did something. That was divine help. The prime minister who doubted, of course, according to the word of the Lord through the prophet, saw it but did not partake of it. But you will partake of it in the name of Jesus. You will partake of it in the name of Jesus. You will partake of it in the name of Jesus. In Revelation chapter 12, we saw how the earth opened up to swallow the flood released by the dragon that wants to consume the woman. That was the help of the Lord. I'm saying this background of this scripture so that you will understand divine help, and we will begin. I will begin to pray for the sake of time. What about the man at the pool of Bethesda? Every time they have a Jewish celebration, the scripture says that the angel of God will come to steer the pool, and anybody that gets into it first, no matter your situation, no matter your sickness, you will get your healing. You will get your healing. And Jesus came to the scene. And Jesus asked the man, what is happening? He said, before I would run there, somebody would have answered. And Jesus said, come on, rise up. Your healing is perfected. Your healing is perfected. What about Genesis chapter 14? The children of Israel were between the Red Sea and the Egyptian army pursuing them. Lo and behold, the people have told Moses, is there no grave in Egypt that you want us to die in the wilderness? And Moses looked up to heaven and instruction came forth. That was divine help that parted the sea. I want you to know you may have been in the midst of situation where you look going forward, no going, going backward, no going. You are just stuck in the middle. Hey, but tonight, the God of divine intervention is in the house. In the course of the day, when I was singing to the Lord, and he brought this song back to me. Come and lay down the body that you have carried from the sanctuary. God is here. The one that will divinely help is here. You are going to lift up your voice. You are going to pray. You are going to say, oh God, divinely cause me. To favor me and my loved ones, to favor our righteous cause. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lord, cause men to favor me. Cause men to favor my righteous cause. Cause men to favor my loved ones. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Is it not written that the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord? The Lord does it wherever he needs them. And you finally say something. No man can help you except God touch that man. Whether the man be a believer or a non-believer, except God touch it. Lift up your voice and ask for divine intervention. Lord, touch men to begin to favor me. In the name of Jesus, Lord, help us. In
the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let me share this testimony. I just remember this, and we are going to be praying the next prayer point. When we were serving in Anambra, I remember that particular time that our alawi was not paid on time.
lo and behold, everybody in the Lord did not have food. I only have a bit of gari, and of course it has gone down. I said, God, this bit of gari must not finish until our alawi was paid. Until our alawi is paid. So ask me how that it did not finish, but it did not finish until alawi was paid. Maybe perhaps I could have asked that it should not finish so that I would not buy gari all through service here. But the Lord divinely intervened. What was not enough became enough. What was not enough became enough. You are going to pray. You are going to say, oh Lord, by divine intervention, turn my economy around. Turn my economy around. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lord, by divine intervention, turn my economy around. Turn my economy around. Turn my economy around. Whether you're buying, you're selling, your finances, or what have you, by divine intervention, by divine intervention, turn my economy around. Turn my economy around. Rabosi, Rabba, Kabasi, the Yoke, Libra, Huka, Basuka, Liga, Libra, Bora, Rabi, Peru, Seguri, Basuke, Rabi, Guri, Basuke, Rosuke, Lika, 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 Suke, Peru, Sapon, Yokodo, Bosuke, Liga, Ria, in the name of Jesus. Listen to this, listen to this. Some of us, you may not understand what we mean by turn our economy around. See, for me, I tell my people at work, when they pay us certain money, that take note to that it was because of me they paid this money, not because of me. You are just enjoying of it because of this needed to be met at that material time. We have paid some money the last time, and you know, some of my colleagues, they knew before that, they say, ah, COVID, we did not make profit, they will not give us anything. I say, your own. Okay, they did not even pay everybody, but they will pay me. So when they paid us, they say, when they see some other person, say, now buy your prayer. That was divine intervention. Even when they were crying out, we did not make enough money, the fears were here and there, what have you. If they did not pay us, then nothing we will do. After all, it is bonus. They would have decided not to pay. You're going to lift up your voice. Lord, by divine intervention,
oh Lord,
turn my economy around.
Turn my economy around.
Turn my economy around. Rabasuka Alike, Rabipe Rusuke, Rabosha Huka, Rasuke, Raboshani Rabbe, Supra, Leka, Rondo, Rosupra, Mesoro, Libra, Okobo, Supra, Rosute, Lebo, Supra, Rababo, Kosute, Ina, Robo, Supra, Rosode, Rabasuka, Okobo, Supra,
oh Lord,
Supra, Bagana, Basuka, Labo, Sukele, Rababa, Babo, Sukele, told his children. He said, Lord, behold, hear me, I'm going to send angels to take you to the places I have prepared for you. To places I've prepared for you. You are going to lift up your voice. You are going to say, oh God, by divine intervention, let your angels take me to the places you have prepared for me. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Receive the ministry of angels. Receive the ministry of angels that obey God. Let them begin to take you from the place that he has prepared for you. Lord was in the midst of trouble when Sodom and Gomorrah was being destroyed. Lord says, with the way thinking is money, I may not be able to escape. The angels have to intervene. Until you are saved, nothing will happen. Until you are taken to the place of safety, until you are taken to the place of your provision, from the places of your sustenance, lift up your voice. grace, by divine intervention, let your angels take you to the places you have prepared for me. In the name of Jesus. Jehoshaphat was faced with three countries in numbers, in everything he knew he could not match them. But he turned to the Lord, and the prophet said, "Don't worry, we are going to go singing." And when they went singing, that was one battle that Israel did not shoot an arrow. Israel did not shoot an arrow. What happened? Moab and the Amorites, they gathered together. They destroyed Mount Seir. After they destroyed Mount Seir, the Moabites and the Amorites, they faced themselves and killed them. Now, this is where I'm going. The Bible says that Israel was not gathering the spoils for good 3 days. They were gathering what? The spoils. You are going to lift up your voice. You are going to say, "Oh God, by divine intervention, let men begin to use their resources to favor me. Even the resources of your enemies, they will use to favor you." Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Like those three lepers also. Like those three lepers also. God magnify the sound of their feet. And the enemy ran away. The lepers went and be backing and backing. They said, "Oh, we wouldn't have gone well if we don't go to tell the people." Rapos Kapali, Rapas Kenegede, Sopra, the Rakandosa, the Rapasagadashi, Manabasate, Manabosa, Supreme de Bokobosude. Do you know what it means? But people have been looking for you to bless you. They have been looking for you to bless you. That's the final intervention. Rapas Ataligadabosa, the Rapasate, the Rokoshene, the Rokoshene, the Rokoshene, the Rokoshene, the Rokoshene, the Rokoshene, the in the name of Jesus, let it be so. In Jesus' name we pray. For time, you are going to pray this one more prayer. You are going to ask, "Lord, by your divine intervention, cause my faith to spread abroad. Announce me. Announce me." Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. "Lord, announce me. Let my faith be spread abroad for good, for greater impact, for your kingdom." Open your mouth and begin to thank him for answering prayers. Thank him for answering prayers. Thank him because he has done more than we have asked. He has done more than our imagination. Give him all the praise.
Father, we thank you, God. Father, we bless you, God. Father, we give you praise, God. We give you glory. We are still praying. Lord, have a strong God that we should pray. Briefly, just so that you catch your breath. Start to catch your breath. I'll just show us a few things. I will expand on it on Sunday. It's our season of divine intervention. I will expand on it on Sunday. And but just to drop this, so I'm using, we're going to use it to pray. Two scriptures that speaks to Kish was here yesterday, so it was the only one that was around for. When we begin to talk about divine intervention, we are talking about God showing up at the nick of time. Divine intervention is speaking or declaring that God showing up at the nick of time, just when it is most necessary, most crucial, most important. When we talk about divine intervention, we are saying that God will just show up to solve a problem, to remove an embarrassment, to provide a blessing, to meet a need, to calm a nerve, to calm a Red Sea, to just solve that issue, just at the nick of time. When we talk about divine intervention, we are saying God showing up to deliver you from the clutches of the enemy. Where you see the crocodile has opened his mouth wide, ready, and just about to drop with you, and then someone just snatches you from the jaw of the enemy. That's divine intervention. Acts chapter 12, verse 6 and verse 7. Acts chapter 12, verse 6 and verse 7. And when Herod would have brought him forth, now you know the story. Peter was arrested and was put in prison, and Herod had in mind that by this time tomorrow, very early morning tomorrow, I will go and get Peter and behead him, because I beheaded John, and you know, everything was cool. So Peter was kept in the prison in readiness for his head to be beheaded by the following morning. So that's what the Bible says. And when Aaron would have brought him forth, he was just waiting for the day to break, and Aaron would have brought him forth. The same night, Peter was sleeping between the two soldiers, bound with two chains, and the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and a light shined in the prison, and smote Peter on the side, and raised him up, saying, "Arise up quickly." And his chains fell off from his hands. So the night before the morning, there was a divine intervention for the deliverance of Peter. Back on Sunday, the message, you are getting a foretaste of the message. It's a combination of what divine intervention is by the orchestration of the angelic visitation. In the last couple of days, and those of you who will be on the prayer line tomorrow morning, we're going to pray that angelic visitation. In the last couple of days, God has been dealing with me in those in that regard, and we took time to pray yesterday. So Peter was programmed or planned for his head to be beheaded in the morning, but at night there was angelic visitation and angelic deliverance because of divine intervention. Praise the Lord. So, you see God intervening just at the nick of time. God did not wait for the morning, but in the middle of the night, Peter was delivered. Let's look at another example. Esther chapter 7 and verse 10. That's another example of divine intervention. Esther chapter 7 and verse 10. Esther chapter 7 and verse 10. So, they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai. So Haman had orchestrated the destruction of Mordecai, absolutely unknown to Mordecai. Mordecai was totally oblivious of the fact that there was a gallows erected for him. But by orchestration of divine intervention, the man who erected the gallows was the one who was unbearing and who died. It's called divine intervention, and it's called divine substitution. So, by orchestration of God's divine plan, if you read it, time will not permit us to read it, because if you look at the verse before, and Abner, one of the chamberlains, said before the king, "Behold, the gallows 50 cubits high, which Haman had made for Mordecai, who has spoken good of the king, standing in the house of Haman." Now, who prompted Abner to talk? You know, because I always say, guys, when you read the Bible, let your imagination. Me, I always read the Bible with my imagination. Why? Because that means that this guy knew of the plan. He knew, but he didn't talk until now that God needed to deliver Mordecai. Our alatako, positive alatako. What is alatako in English? I don't know alatako.
Attack.
Is alatako. God orchestrated a positive alatako. Otako. Haman. And that was how Haman's case was moving from bad to worse to worst. You know, he wanted to go and meet with Esther. He's feet stumbled, he fell on the bed. And the king came and said, "Even in my presence, not raped by queen." Why did his feet slip and he fell on the bed? It's called attacko. Oh. It's all about what? Divine orchestration. So everything God will use to divinely intervene on your behalf, it is to send positive attackos, to use things to just bring it about that your enemies will be exposed. So in this instance, Mordecai totally oblivious, unaware of what Haman was planning. Meanwhile, other people knew. But God then forced their mouth to talk. So where the positive attackers were going to keep quiet, God not allowed them to keep quiet. So on your behalf, people that will need to speak positively for you will not keep quiet. So those are those two examples. That will not allow us to do the others. Don't let me finish my sermon of tomorrow or Sunday here. So we are going to pray in this season of divine intervention. The first prayer point you are going to pray is that, oh Lord, the same way you sent the angels to deliver Peter at the nick of time, just at when it was needed, oh Lord, let there be angelic visitation of God to deliver me. This month, lift up your voice and begin to pray. Oh Lord, let there be a angelic visitation to deliver me from everything that to be delivered on. Let there be a angelic visitation to deliver me in the name of Jesus. Zakata Baba, Erebo Sokoto, Rembasi Kato Baba, Iya Baba Soko Ya Baba, Ansuka Te Mago Boyaba. Oh Lord, angelic visitation, angelic visitation, angelic visitation to deliver me, O God, from the trap of the enemy. To deliver me, O God, from every onslaught. To deliver me, O God, from every lack. To deliver me, O God, from every pain. To deliver me, O God, from every heartache. To deliver me, O God, from every poverty. To deliver me, O God, from every stumble. To deliver me, O God, from every limitation. In the name of Jesus, everything has kept me down. Angelic intervention, God. Angelic intervention, God. Divine intervention. Divine intervention. Oh Lord,
Lord, deliver me, O God, from every onslaught of the enemy, from every plan of the enemy, from everything, O God, that the enemy wants to use, O God, to destroy me, from every destructive tendency. Deliver me, O God. Oh Lord, deliver me, O God. Deliver me, O God. Deliver me, O God. Send your angels, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We're going to pray some night one and Mazdini in particular. Of course, you are familiar with the whole of the chapter, the prayer of deliverance, but chapter verse 3, some night one and verse 3. Surely he shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noise of pestilence. Every arrow of the enemy, every noise of pestilence, every waging war, every attacker, is it a family attacker? Is it a workplace attack? Is it a business place attack? Is it anything that is a source of attack? It is called a war that is waged against you. You are going to pray this prayer because listen to me. Everything that has not let you go in the past 5 months, this month you must break loose them. Everything that has caged you in, that has etched you in, that has prevented us in a sort of blockade. You heard when Mr. Epaya was talking? Listen to me. You heard when he was talking about, you know, the lepers. Now, the story before the lepers was the fact that Samaria was strictly locked in. It was a siege. They were kept in, no movement. It was a siege. They surrounded the whole of Samaria, no movement. They were etched in. So when they finished all their supply, they couldn't get any supply. It was a caging in. It was a siege. So everything that cages you in and limits you, and you can't move. No, you can't move left, you can't move right. It's like being in a straight jacket. You are going to pray, and I need you to pray, and I need you to pray very fervently. Things that are limited you, every source of limitation that you have not allowed you to pass forth, it is a siege. He says that you will deliver me surely. Surely the Lord will deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noise of pestilence. Oh Lord, this day I receive my deliverance from every snare of the fowler, from every noise of pestilence, from everything that came me in. Limited me, prevented me from begging for. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Sarobo sakata baba, retete taboshka, ranta kulaba, ligeso padaboshka, le pasokoto. I break away from every chain and shackle. From the Lord, deliver me. Surely the Lord will deliver me. Surely the Lord will deliver me. Sarobo sakata baba, ligeso kababa, ratushka baba. Lord, I break away from every limitation. I break away from every stronghold. I break away from things that have hindered me. Lord, whatever is the source of limitation that has not allowed me to break on, that has not allowed me to go forward, everything that has not allowed me to go forward, I break away. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Psalm 124, verse 7. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. You see that being repeated again? The snare is broken and we are escaped.
Oh Lord,
where they have put my name,
in
a bottle and locked it up, and said you cannot escape. Where they have put my name in a God, what is a God? Oh, Kelly, what is that God?
Yes.
Am I correct? Kelly, is that what came to me? But I thought the English is God. Yeah. When they have put your name inside Kelly and locked it up, you know that power Kelly is called God. Yeah? And they have hung it and said, you, no escape for you. Where they have tied my name in a bottle and dropped it in the deep sea and said, except this bottle will float. If this bottle cannot float, then you can never arise. Hey! Where they have said, we tie you like an effigy. Where you have been tied like an effigy. And they say that, except you are able to lose this effigy, you can never escape. Bible says, in that Psalm 124, we are going to use it to pray. It says, our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Oh, the snare of the enemy is broken over my life. I escape. My husband escaped. My wife escaped. My children escaped. My destiny escaped. My business escaped. My wisdom escaped. My prosperity escaped. My advancement escaped. My job escaped. My blessings escaped. My fruitfulness escaped. My promotion escaped. Everything about me escaped from the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken. The snare is broken. The snare is broken. Lord, we escaped. Lord, Lord, I've escaped from every stronghold, from every limitation in the name of Jesus, from ancestral blockage, every ancestral blockage, every limited time, I escape. Every evil pattern, I escape from every evil pattern.
Psalm 44, verse 7. But thou hast saved us from our enemies and hast put them to shame that hated us. Thou hast saved us from our enemies and put to shame those that hate us. Verse 5. Through thee we will push down our enemies. Through thy name we'll tread them under that rise up against us. So you are going to use these two verses to pray, but you start from verse 7. But thou hast saved us from our enemies and put them to shame that hated us. So, oh Lord, everyone waiting for my downfall, waiting for my shame, waiting for my lack, waiting for me to come and beg them. All those who are waiting for my sack, waiting for my poverty, waiting for my loss. Oh Lord, put them to shame. Put them to shame. In the name of Jesus, put them to shame, oh God. Thou hast saved us from our enemies. I'm put to shame. God, let it go. All those who are waiting for me to come and beg them for bread, waiting for me to come and beg them for food, all those who are waiting for my loss, waiting for my death, waiting for my calamity, waiting for my downfall, waiting for evil to come in. Oh Lord, put them to shame. Lift your hands and pray. All those who are waiting to hear that, oh, I just lost my job. Oh, I just lost that contract. Oh, I just lost that pregnancy. Oh, I didn't get that job. I didn't get that contract. Oh, my son just failed an exam. Oh, they are just deported my friend. Oh, any evil report that many people are waiting for. So wait forever. In Jesus' name we pray. So now we're going to read the verse 5. Verse 5 says that true God will push down our enemies. Through your name, O Lord, we will tread them under that rise up against us. Oh Lord, I tread under every enemy that rises against me. I trample over them. I trample over every opposition. Every enemy, I trample over you. After the others come at one, it says that you trample upon the other. I trample on that.
I crush
every enemy that the Lord wants to forget. I break your head. I crush you right now. I crush the head of the enemy. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder. The young man and the dragon shall thou trample under your feet. Every dragon I trample under my feet. In Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen.
Let me pray one prayer in that regard. Psalm 105, verse 19 and verse 19. Psalm 105, verse 19 and verse 20. Psalm 105, 19 and 20. Until the time that his word came, the word of the Lord tried him. The king sent and loosed him, even the ruler of the people, and let him go free. The king sent and loosed him, and let him go free. Therefore, O Lord, by the word of the Lord, that you have spoken, every enemy that has held me bound, I lose myself and I let go. I go free. I lose myself. I lose myself. I lose myself and I go free. And I go free. He says that the king said, I lose him, even the Lord of the people, and let him go free. I am set free. I'm liberated. I lose myself. I lose myself from every bondage, from every limitation, from every stronghold. I lose myself. I lose myself. I lose myself. I lose myself. I'm set free. Bible says, if the Son of Man shall make you free, you are free indeed. I'm free indeed. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let's take one more prayer point for ourselves and then we'll pray for the nation. Luke chapter 1 and verse 26 and 27. That was at TPC on Sunday, I think, or what was it? Luke chapter 1, verse 26 and verse 27. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. Now, I need to understand this, because if you read the two verses, you understand that the angel Gabriel could not make a mistake, because it was a specific directive. The description was very clear. Angel Gabriel, you are going to a city called a country of Galilee, to a city named Nazareth. So don't go anywhere but that place. Galilee to a city of Nazareth. Now, you are going to meet a woman espoused to Joseph, Just in case that you are wondering, this Joseph is of the house of David. Now, this woman, she's a virgin. And then this woman, her name is Mary. So there can't be many of them specific. It was a specific direct message to somebody specific. And it was in the sixth month. So what is the prayer? I told us that on Sunday I'll talk about angelic ministration. So you are going to pray. I'll give you maybe 5 minutes because of time. You pray all manners of prayer you want to pray for angelic visitation. Just in case that there are many Tunde Daudus. Oh Lord, it is Tunde Daudu living in Lagos. Just in case there are too many Tunde Daudus living in Lagos. It is Tunde Daudu living in Lubeju. Just in case there are too many Tunde Daudus living in Lubeju. It is Tunde Daudu living at number 6. Oh, you only it. Just in case there's one other guy in my neighbors, it is 6A. Oh Lord, Tunde Daudu of number 6A. Oh, you only show it. Off Shuamangaji, off Koka. In Lubeju, Lagos, you cannot miss it. So, oh Lord, let there be angelic visitation to me. What is that angelic visitation you need? Now, it's left to you. Whatever angelic visitation you need, you have better tell God that this is my address. Oh Lord, this is my address. This is me. Let me describe where I am. So that angel Gabriel will not make mistakes. I'm carrying my blessings somewhere else. I'm not living in America yet. It is Nigeria. It is Lagos, Nigeria. It is in Lubeju, Lagos. It is up to Amagadi, Lagos. Can you pray? Can you pray? Oh Lord, in the 6 months, the Lord sent angel Gabriel to a woman called Mary. This man is not ordinary Mary, she's a virgin. This man is not just a virgin, she's espoused to Joseph. This Joseph lives in the city of Nazareth, called the city of Nazareth in Galilee. Can you lift up your voice and pray? Oh Lord, locate me. Let the angels locate me with a package. What is that package? What is that package this month? What is that package this month? Can you lift up your voice and pray? Can you lift up your voice and pray? Oh Lord, in these 6 months, let my blessing locate me. Let my promotion locate me. Let my lift locate me. Lift up your voice and pray. Can somebody that is alive pray? Can somebody that is living pray? Your package must not miss you. Don't let somebody else carry your package. Don't let somebody else carry your package. You have better be specific. Mention your address. Mention who you are. Mention your age. Mention what it is. Let that package not miss your God. This package must not go to my neighbor. I am a Togo. My neighbor must not collect my package. What is the package that you are talking about? Is it healing? Is it health? Is it deliverance? Is it fruitfulness? Is it financial breakthrough? Is this financial deadline? Is it promotion? Is it mental business breakthrough? Is it a job? Is it a vital partner? Oh Lord, this is my address. This is my location. Let that package be delivered. Let it be delivered. Let it not be sold. Let it not become undelivered package. It must be delivered at home. This is my phone number. Tell God your phone number so that the angel can call you ahead. Oh Lord, this is my phone number. This is my email address. The angel is to send a good news. This is my email address. Oh. This is my phone number. This is my Twitter handle. This is my LinkedIn account. This is my Facebook page. The angel is to follow you, like you, tweet you, retweet you. You have better give the angel all your details now. Am I engaged by public talking? Am I public event? Giving God all your handles. This is my handle, Lord. Let the angel begin to broadcast it. Let the angel begin to broadcast it. Let the angel begin to broadcast it. What is your Twitter handle? What is your Facebook page? What is your IG address? Angel Gabriel, this is it, Lord. Begin to tweet it. Begin to broadcast it. In the 6 months, in the 6 months, in the 6 months,
What's your business name? Can you tell your neighbor your business name? Where is your address? Where is your office address? Agent Gabriel, can you locate me in my office? Can you give Agent Gabriel the address of your the office address of your boss? So I can go and visit your boss and tell your boss, promote this guy, promote this guy. Oh Lord, he sent your angels this for the world. They will look at me. They will not miss it. Link me to those that will matter. I'm on Facebook, bro. Link me to those that matter. I have an email, I have a phone number. Link me. Fantastic phone call. Supernatural phone call. Can you pray? Can you pray? What is the package that Gabriel is bringing? Is it the fruit of the womb? You see a revolution of a trouble that has been troubling you. Is it peace? Is it security? In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. As you have taken this prayer points, every one of them, the ones taken went through Mr. Bio session, and now may the Lord hearken and give us a speedy answer in the name of Jesus. This season of divine intervention, the Lord will speedily intervene on our behalf in the name of Jesus. Every prayer point becomes testimonies. That package which Gabriel is bringing will lay hold on it in the name of Jesus. It's not elude us, it will escape us. Nobody will hijack it. It will not be undelivered package. We will be at home and we'll take delivery of it. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Maybe because of time, I want us to pray for the nation. I need us to pray for the nation. Every day, you hear one news or the other that troubles your mind about the level of insecurity. Just about 30 minutes before the fast service started, I saw on channels of a youth leader of PDP in Imo State that was murdered. His property, his building, his house, in burned down. The all manners of atrocity that is going on. I was discussing with somebody recently, a couple of days ago. He said to me that he is not traveling to the East anytime soon. That now in the East, they just catch people. They don't even need to know who you are. They just size you up. They just catch you like this. Just catch you and, you know, the people not locate you anymore. Is that bad? But I want us to pray. You see, one of the things I always tell the parents is that when you behave like an ostrich, you bury your head to the sun and say, well, thank God I'm in Lagos. At least I don't know the apple for Lagos. And the East, I know they go eat not. You don't know that very soon it will come home. Like somebody said that they came for the blood. I said, thank God, I know he's black. We didn't talk. They came for the fat. I said, thank God, you see, I sleep. Before they come, say they don't carry the fat. They will keep coming until there's nobody to come for again. Until you, they come for you. So it is in our interest that we pray for peace
for this insecurity and lawlessness to come to an end. And more importantly, for the wicked, for the evil that the wicked is planning to come upon their head. We're going to use a couple of scriptures to quote Psalm 7 and verse 9. Psalm 7 verse 9. O Lord, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end, but establish the just. For the righteous God that tries the heart of the wicked. Everyone who is perpetrating wickedness. Somebody's status that one man was talking, even though I didn't really believe all the things he said, was saying that a 13-year-old girl was coming from church and they caught the girl, you know, caught her and took out her heart. His whole point was that people should not go to church. I don't believe that. But the point is, he said, what has a 13-year-old child done for anybody? That is the height of wickedness. Is the wickedness that is operating now is scary because it knows no boundary. People's heart are seared. People now are committing atrocities that even you will shudder. In fact, guys, even the devil they fear this one. 13-year-old. So it's not a case of maybe anything. Just 13-year-old. You are looking for ritual money. I don't know. So there's so much atrocity. Do you want to talk about the pedophiles who are just, you know, assaulting and molesting young people? Do you want to talk of those who would just kill and cut into pieces as if they are cutting Nama? So all this wickedness, oh Lord, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. So I don't really talk about this. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand in the gap and we pray for Nigeria. Oh Lord, let the act of wickedness come to an end in Nigeria. Lift up your voice and pray. Please pray with concern. Please pray with concern. Please pray with concern. Oh Lord, arise, oh Lord. In Nigeria, waste of lives, waste of properties, killing, maybe destruction, acid, and all kinds of calamity. Let this come to an end, oh God. We put an end, O Lord, to every act of lawlessness, killing, maybe destruction. We put an end to acid. We put an end to dreadful destruction. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Time is on our side. We need to move a bit faster. Proverbs chapter 11 and verse 21. Proverbs 11, 21. Do and join to hand. The wicked shall not go unpunished, but the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. What and join to hand is that whatever conspiracy, whatever gang up, whatever, you know, cover up, whatever lie, whatever, you know, you don't cover up, it says, and join to hand, the wicked will not go unpunished. I'm going to pray, oh Lord, all those who are perpetrating wickedness, let judgment come upon them now. Oh Lord, rain your judgment upon the wicked of in the land. Rain your judgment, Lord, waste them, Lord, destroy them, oh Lord, punish them. And join to hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished. The wicked shall not go unpunished. Let the judgment of the wicked come upon them now. Let the judgment of the wicked come upon them now. Oh Lord, waste them. As they are wasted, let them be wasted. As they are destroyed, let them be destroyed. Thank you.
Oh Lord, let judgment come upon the head of the wicked. I'm going to hand the wicked to go punish. Let judgment begin. Let judgment begin now. Let judgment begin now. Where's the wicked? In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Just in case you say pastor, but those scriptures were written as Old Testament. So you know this fundamental prayer is Old Testament. 2 Thessalonians 1:6. 2 Thessalonians 1:6. 2 Thessalonians 1:6. See, it is a righteous thing with God. So God is saying that it is when He wants to make trouble for those that trouble you, it is a righteous thing. So it is okay for you to pray. I want to So he says it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. Every troubler of Nigeria, every troubler of this nation, oh Lord, recompense tribulation upon their head. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Every troubler of Nigeria, every troubler of this nation, all those who are fomenting trouble, all those who are making, all those who are digging up trouble, all those who are fomenting trouble, Lord, recompense tribulation upon them. Oh Lord, bring tribulation upon them. Lord, consume them by tribulation, consume them by all trouble. Let them be in particular their trouble. The trouble that they are cooking, oh God, let them eat the trouble. Let them enter the trouble. Let them, like Haman was hung upon the gallows that he made for mankind. Let them hang upon their gallows. Let them fall upon their feet inside their feet. Oh Lord, recompense tribulation upon the travelers of Nigeria. Upon the travelers of Nigeria. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Finally, because of time, Ezekiel 13:23. I will read two versions for us. Ezekiel 13:23 says that therefore you shall see no more vanity nor divine invasion. For I will deliver my people out of your hand, and shall know that I am the Lord. NIV says that therefore you will no longer see false visions or practice divination. I will save my people from your hands, and then you will know that I am the Lord. NLT says that because of all of this,
you will no longer talk of seeing visions that you never saw. Nor would you make predictions. For I will rescue my people from your grasp. I will rescue my people from your grasp. So we are going to pray, oh Lord, rescue Nigeria from the grasp of those who are oppressing it. Deliver the people from the hand of the oppressor. Oh Lord, deliver Nigeria from the hands of the oppressor. I will rescue my people. I will deliver my people from the hands of your hands. I will rescue my people from your grasp. I will deliver my people from the hand of the oppressor. Oh Lord, deliver Nigeria. You can pass that prayer for yourself as well. Deliver Nigeria, grip of your vessel. Oh Lord, deliver Nigeria from the grip and the grasp of your vessel, of the wicked. Deliver Nigeria from Boko Haram. Deliver Nigeria from evil X-Men. Deliver Nigeria from Boso. Deliver Nigeria from IPOM. Deliver Nigeria from ISOBA. Deliver Nigeria, oh God, from every terrorist attack. Deliver Nigeria. Oh Lord, deliver Nigeria. Then you will deliver. For I will rescue my people from your grasp. Then you will know. In Jesus' mighty name we are praised.
Amen.
As we are prayed concerning this nation, concerning this land, concerning our country Nigeria, Lord, do unto us, O God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Deliver Nigeria from the stronghold of the enemy.
Amen.
Lord, deliver Nigeria from those who have held up by the jugular. Lord, set Nigeria free.
Amen.
No more act of wickedness.
Amen.
No more act of wanton destruction.
Amen.
No more wastages.
Amen.
No more killing and maiming.
Amen.
No more, no more, no more bloodshed of the innocent. We reject it. We stand against it. Lord, let the wickedness of the wicked come to a permanent halt.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
And also, God, we are covered in the name of Jesus. 1,000 people at our side, 10,000 people at our right hand. Only with our eyes we see and behold the wicked of the wicked, because we are safe and secure in you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We will not be partakers of the evil.
Amen.
Lord, the covenant of life that we enjoy in the King Chamber will speak for us,
Amen.
Will speak for our loved ones,
Amen.
Will speak for every member of our family.
Our
going out and our coming is covered,
Amen.
There shall be no loss. There shall be no cry.
Amen.
There shall be no outtake of any kind.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you. Very quickly, we partake of the communion. And this also brings the let somebody bring the anointing on the world. Anoint for Cobra for safety and security. And covenant of God for men and for us. Father, we thank you for the communion as we are putting the covenant table of God. Father, we ask you, God, that you prepare our hearts and make us worthy to receive it. Lord, we sanctify the elements. It comes the body and blood of Jesus. As a symbol, as we partake of this, if anybody is sick in the body, let it take place. If anyone is confused to God, let there be clarity. By receiving of the anointing, you will be broken. As we partake of the communion of God, every yoke of bondage, every yoke of lack, every yoke of stagnancy and stasis is removed. We step into our progress, advancement, and lifting in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Please wait. We'll take it together. So please, once you're served, don't take it here. Just wait. Make sure everybody is served.
Yeah. because of this, as we partake of the communion, as we partake of the bread, let it nourish our bodies, let it restore life unto us. Break and eat. As we partake of the body and also of the blood of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus speak to us like the blood of God. Let it speak, live in and out unto us. In Jesus' name, drink. Can I have a little saucer? Is anybody sick? Is anybody having? Are you feeling sick, weak? Is anyone that is feeling sick or weak? Please come forward. Come forward. Can we have another round of the communion for this evening? Let us follow it up. How many people do we have? Sorry, we have a communion between the dead. Six. Can we have
seven?
Seven. That it will go as we take it, or as we take it, that Lord, every weariness and feebleness, one of you, I don't know who now, you are feeling physically drained, as if no, you can't, as if your leg can't even carry you. Is that? Let there be a flow. Let there be a strength.
receive a new strength, feebleness and weakness goes.
I'm By virtue of this corporate fast, oh God, every one of us faithful, they wanted to be free. or even because of mercy, those who did not but came to pray, let the blessings that are due to obedience, let the blessings that are due to us, O God. As you have prayed, you have unlocked every door of blessing. As it's flowing from the earth, every one of us will partake of it. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. And by the grace of God and unction, conferred on me, by the head of the church upon my Father the Lord, I decree and declare these 3 days of prayer and fasting will be brought, and the blessings will never be over. The blessings will be continuous. The reward will be continuous. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Damn your spirit of the Lord. So now, all the offering you are writing in that way, you are going to do. Shall we lift up our offering as we bless God? And we thank Him for such a wonderful time and for His grace. Sorry, we couldn't take the study, that study. I knew we would not be able to. The Holy Spirit told me I was disobedient. He said, we will not take the Bible study. I was prepared. So, next time I will learn my lesson. But we'll take it next month, next Wednesday. Father, we thank you for the privilege to give it to you. We thank you for the seed in our hands. We thank you because you have given seed to the soil, you have given bread to the eater. As we sow this seed of God, Lord, it will unlock our blessings. It will open up our lifting. It will bring unto us every divine intervention for proof in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Praise the Lord. We'll drop off and I will take the announcement simultaneously because of time. So, who is carrying the basket around? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, remember, this Sunday is the first Sunday of the month. So it's our fresh impartation. As the CA will say, if you do not participate, you will not serve. So HODs, MICs, please begin to sensitize your people. Send them SMS, send them WhatsApp on your platform. Everybody come and come early for the fresh impartation this Sunday. Absolutely important. Like we mentioned recently, this year, month has declared a month of divine intervention. And I trust God that every service, God will be showing Himself and intervening on our behalf in Jesus' name. So get ready, get prepared, and be ready to be partakers of it. Sunday the 17th is Father's Day. I've sent a message to your coordinator, to our staff coordinator. Both coordinator and staff, they are not here now. Ilukwaju, they are having a 2-day program. The man, I sent it to the coordinator, the man puts it on your platform to say, well, we plan when we go to do their Father's Day. 20, oh, wow, where did I see 17 from? 17 is somebody's wedding, though. That was in my head. Sorry. 20th, Sunday 20th, Father's Day. 17th is Baby Coca's wedding, sorry. So, Sunday 20th. So, the interview is having, they are doing 2 days headquarters. So we, I don't know whether we'll be able to do 2 days, but even in 1 day, let's be ready. Please. You saw what children did. We saw what women did. So fathers in the house. Do you have fathers in the house?
Yes.
Where are the fathers in the house?
Yes.
Okay, you are not a father. No, maybe that's not be a father. Numbers 14, 28. God will remind you, so many years ago when I was calling Father, I said, you're not Father. Because this is a prophetic church. So, please, let's go as well. Then, Sunday the 27th, which is the last Sunday in the month, is our what? Traditional Inheritance Sunday. Who are the Ibokwelus? Ibokwelus?
Yes!
Who are the Yoruba Batis? Who are the Edo people? Wado. Are you Edo?
No.
Okay, I said Edo. Prof, are you not a Delta? I know. The middle Deltas. The south. Who are the job people here? So please, Mr. Bola, you have this assignment. I'm not seeing action. I want action. This Sunday, I want to see the various groups. So it's not just singing, it's not just dressing.
You have food, you want to bring food. Your local dialect, you are waiting, bring it. You have a special dance that you used to dance. Come and dance. To the glory of God, not a masquerade dance. Come on, masquerade dance. Before you are manifesting, it's a baptized spirit. If you have dress, your dress, come and bring your dress. So, all choreograph everything to the glory of God. So, we want to have that. Praise the Lord. So, that's Sunday the 27th. So, remember this first Sunday is corporate Sunday, so we dress corporately. English prayer. Praise the Lord. Have I anything I just need? No, I've tried. Shall I say my faith? I'll do it. Any first time, I can't say any first time I hear, except the first time I say spirit or in the online.
We are grateful, oh Lord. We are grateful, Lord.
We thank you for yoke that you have broken. We thank you for liberty in the spirit. We thank you for the blessing that we have received. Lord, as we go, oh God, we go in the power of your might. We go by the name of your spirit. And we ask, oh God, that every blessing we have received are permanent in Jesus' name. We cover ourselves in the blood of Jesus. We cover our families in the blood of Jesus. We cover our going up and our coming in the blood of Jesus. It is well with us. It is well with us. We will not suffer shame. We will not suffer sorrow. We have spent time in your presence, O God. Lord, only shouts of joy we had in our courts, O God. We are breaking forth on all sides, O God. Lord, it's a new beginning. It's greater levels, O God. It's the sixth month, O God. For six glorious things beginning to happen unto us, O God. Blessed be your name. We pray for those who have joined us online. The same blessing that we have received, O God, let them be partaker thereof, O God. In the name of Jesus. When we meet on Sunday, we'll have testimony to the glory of your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Shall we share the grace together? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be another with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy upon us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord, forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 16, verse 11. For the Lord is sure of the path of life, and his presence is fullness of joy. At his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Amen. Shalom, the Lord bless you. Have a pleasant night rest in Jesus' name.